Hello, it's Keith from KMA's Korner. How are you doing today? I am in a sea of red. Oh, you can't see me? Oh my gosh, there I am, hiding behind the red buds of nether wart awesomeness. Yeah, actually, there's nothing awesome about nether wart. Hate the stuff, but it serves a purpose, so we make it. Oh, and there's a spider hanging out in my nether wart. The cows are getting out of my little farm there. Every time I log in, you know, if they're halfway in that thing, they kind of pop up. So I thought that was a kind of a foolproof thing back there, but look at all these cows. So I got something to talk about real quick. It's nothing major. Somebody had mentioned, after the first episode was released of the reset of this world, I had mentioned that I wasn't going to be doing servers anymore because why should I play on servers if I'm not going to be recording with people? There are definitely some ups to servers. And those ups are, you know, you can join a server and somebody's already got a freaking guardian temple done. So if you need magic lanterns, the sea lanterns, like what I want to use in there, then I could just go to a already created guardian temple thing and say thank you, buddy, for doing one of the hardest and most boring things in the world in Minecraft and making a guardian farm and steal some glass. Not steal, but you know, when they make the farms, it's always there for your use. So it is a plus in the server, especially an established one, that you have access to goods like that. But it's still not worth it to me to stay on a server, because servers you play with other people, and yes, I play with other people, and once in a while I'll even go into Mumble, but I'm not in a situation where I can record, and most of my Minecraft stuff is based on recording. So yes, I enjoy playing the game, but I'm usually on a goal to record an episode or working on something to record an episode. So very rarely do I go and derp with people and just shoot the shit, because I have stuff going on in the background. Come on, guys, do I need to push you in? Get in there. Get in there, buddy. Yeah, that's... In the old days, if I stood in the corner here, I'd be shot off right now. But... You want some too, Mr. Spider-Man? So, and another thing, if you actually pay attention to my stats, excuse me, sir, and look at my views and stuff, you will see... Oh, I have arrows again. Yay. small things in life. You will see that my server videos actually get 2 to 3 times more views than the single player videos. So if I want to be doing YouTube, why am I going away from what you guys want? And it's really not you guys. There's a core group of people that watch my single player, and the people on the server are watching my server videos because they belong to the server and they're just kind of interested to see what's going on. They're not really supporters of my channel so much as they are just checking out what's going on in the server and stuff and going, oh look, I know that place, oh I remember working over there, oh I ran through there, oh I remember seeing that building there. And it's kind of cool to see, you know, the world that you play in on a video, and some people watch that. I'm kind of rambling here, but I kind of wanted to get the explanation out that, yes, the videos I make on servers, I gotta do this, the videos I make on the servers get a ton more views than this series. Even though, yes, I would like to make it as a YouTuber, I want to do it on my terms, and I'm not really upsetting people by not making videos on servers. The only person I can really say that might be upset that I'm not making videos anymore on server is Hal, who runs the Serenity server. Awesome dude. Does a lot of programming. And he really likes, he wants his server to do well, and he's probably not going to be, I can't say unhappy, but he's going to be a little disappointed I'm not going to be making any more videos on there anymore. But other than him, I don't see any collateral side effects, other than maybe my channel getting smaller for a little while. But I don't care, because I'm doing this for my fun. Yes, there are some people I like to please also, so I do certain stupid things and, you know, kind of have fun with it. But ultimately, I'm in this for me, and if I'm doing something I don't really want to do, even though it may result in less views, so be it. And that's basically what I wanted to get out on my chest, because after I said I wasn't going on the servers, I looked at my views, and like, the Keith Plays series gets 4 to 8 views maybe per video, but my server videos, they get 25 to sometimes 40 views. So why would I want to give that up? Well, I don't want 3 single player worlds, and I could just specifically hang on a server and make all my videos on a single server and do it kind of like a single player world and get those views. But that's kind of, I don't know, that's just something I don't really want to do, because I want to be in control of the world. This world looks freaking awesome. I haven't even gone exploring yet, except for to go find sand. I don't even remember which direction I went to go get the sand, but I went in one of the directions about 1200 blocks and found a desert and got some sand, and the cactus was really what I needed, and the sand for this. I mean, I could have gotten sand from the little water pools and stuff, but that's not where you farm sand from. So basically, I'm done with the server play, even though that's where most of my views are, and that's okay with me. I'm not here to, you know, steal views, and not steal views, but do anything I possibly can to get views. It's not just the way I am. So what we're doing today, now that's out of the way, is I'm going to clear out a big hall here around the bottom of this. It's going to be a circular hall, which means that this whole area is going to be probably destroyed. And it's going to be made out of diorite, and there's going to be a dome. Not a huge dome, not like a Minecraft Nether Hub dome that Etho and B-Dubs made, but a dome probably 10 or 15 blocks high. And I think the walls will probably go up 10 or 15 blocks. I haven't figured it out yet. But so I'm going to just clear out a whole bunch of stuff, and I don't know, I figure out the dimensions of what I want to do and how I want to set this up. And because the part of the reason why I'm doing this way instead of doing the walls of the track, is I'm having a real hard time deciphering what I want to do with the walls and the track. I'm thinking of like colored wool, you know, lines going up each one to make it kind of, let's do that again. And that's not how it's going to be. It's going to be made out of diorite or something. So I want to work on down here first, figure out what I want to do, then I'm going to make the model for the walls on here from what I do down here. So hopefully working down here will make it easier to decipher what's going to happen up there. So I'll be back when I got some work done. So we've been doing a little work, putting on some music, clearing out a hall, looking straight up, and cutting blocks out. I've decided my great hall where my, I don't know what you want to call this, the zigzag real card of dizziness. But I've been clearing this out, getting tons of blocks. And what you do, or what I do, when I'm clearing out tons of blocks, is I throw on some music and I kind of just zone out and do it. But while I was doing that, You hear, mister. Hello. I cured a zombie villager. And I'm gonna make him... Well, he's already a villager. Oh, and look at this. Just in time. Come here, buddy. Let's see if I can get another one. I didn't know he was around. This is kind of cool that I'm actually doing something. Oh. Are you gonna be coming after that guy? No, 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 no. Come after me. Come after me. Just don't kill me. Let's see. Oh, yeah. That's how you do it. Wow. Let's cover you up. Villager number two. So, if you're ever doing projects like this, do that. And, I don't have any sugar on me. Oh, he's holding. Oh, fuck. Let's give him something to hold. Well, I don't know. Will him holding a sword keep him around? Will you pick that up? Hey. Hey. Nah. I don't know if I can keep this guy because, yeah, you. Will you drop the sword and hold that? No, you won't. Jerk. I am gonna have to. Oh, fuck. I'm gonna go. Oh, I do have one here. Wait. Do I have any apples down here? Or did I just bring one down with me? Screwballs if I only brought one down with me. That's not preparing. Now, what's the odds of this guy being here when I come back? Oops. Oops. When you're clearing up blocks and stuff, and a block falls into the hopper, that's what happens. I need an apple real quick. I have a feeling though, as soon as I get away, he's gonna despawn. Because the sword won't allow him to carry any blocks. It's kind of unfortunate that the sword does that. Now he's gonna have a nice talk on music. Where's my apple? Where's my apples? My apples, my apples. And I'll bring a bunch with me this time. If you've seen my videos before, you know exactly what I'm gonna be doing with these zombies. But I'm just really happy that I was able to capture that guy. Like, I started recording, had no idea that he's around, actually. But he's probably gone because I went farther than... Where are you guys? Come on. Yep. Fucker. Well, at least I have this thing set up for next time. And I got apples. That was unfortunate. So, sorry for that quick excursion from what I was gonna do. Yeah, I decided, even though my last project was a little too big for me and that kinda made me bored with Minecraft a little bit, I decided to make this project a little big. By accident, but I had a series called Minecraft Uncut, and it wasn't a really good series, but it had a decent world, and I was gonna do a mine thing with it. And actually, I am saving this world for the future because I plan on streaming at some time when I get an isolated room where I can actually stream and not get interrupted and have a ton of background noise and while streaming. And I'm gonna pick up that series on stream and finish off that world, because I have some really good ideas for that world. I'm gonna steal a little idea from that world. Oh yeah. I've been waiting for this. I knew one of these blocks was a slime block. Hey. So I may... Actually, I'm not gonna make a slime farm out of this. I'm gonna end up half slabbing the floor here, so nothing can spawn. So that will eliminate any slime spawns, because that's really annoying in that clearing out an area this... I mean, it's not huge, but it's big enough that most likely one of the chunks here is going to be a slime block. On the Minecraft Uncut series, I had a kind of not like a remake of Moria, but an idea based on the Moria from Lord of the Rings. and I had created some amazing pillars I was going to use in the builds. And I ended that series because it wasn't really a fun series. It was more of a series for streaming and not for releasing on YouTube so much. So it would do better while I stream. So I ended it because I can't stream right now. And but I had this idea of the Moria thing, and I'm gonna not make this a Moria, because it's gonna be all kind of like diorite on the walls and stuff. But I'm gonna take a couple of the pillars, and I don't know if I'm gonna stick the pillars right in the corners, the corners, or if I'm gonna stick one, two, like in, you know, four in the center, kind of holding up the center area, and have to walk around the pillars. I haven't really decided, but I'm gonna use the design that I used, or was gonna use for the Moria, and make those pillars here. The pillars would look a lot better in the set, not the center of the room, but not in the corner, because the base and the top fixtures are really intricate and would be nice to see the light of day in the survival world. So that is kind of my idea down here. Gosh, oh, me and the Boston accent sometimes sneaks out. So what I do when I have these bigger projects where I'm just, you know, clearing out huge walls, is I throw on music. And the reason why that is I'm a musician, and in the background you hear songs in all my videos. Some videos have different songs, and this series has a particular song called Kiss Me, and it was like 4 minutes long initially, and it has some weird noises like that kind of distract from the video sometimes. I notice it when I edit, and I kind of want to stray away from that song. But it's a great song, because after I made the 4 minute version, somebody suggested I make an extended one, so I decided to make like a 20 minute version of it, and it's more, not as interesting, but it's more drawn out, which is perfect for the background for these videos, but it's not consistent sounding. So because of my musical background, I was thinking on Saturdays maybe recording me making a new song specifically for the background of my video, just one song for the videos, and continuing doing that. Don't know if I'm gonna stream it. If I stream it, I can't use the mic and talk to the guys and tell you guys what's going on, and I'm really not planning on doing that if I record it for YouTube either, so I don't know. So music has been an integral part of my life, and I kind of want to somehow include it in my YouTube stuff somehow. And so I'm just giving you a heads up. I might put a video up or stream trying to make a song to go behind that I can loop, that can go behind my videos, instead of the one that you're hearing right now in the background. And I think that would be cool. So whenever I do a project like this, I put on a playlist, usually from one band. I have a lot of downloaded music. And when I was clearing out this hall, I was listening to Pink Floyd. Stoner music. Yeah. And what I initially did was I got the new David Gilmour album. He just released a solo album, and was listening to that, and after 5 tracks, I'm like, this kind of sucks. Sorry, David. It's not like your other solo albums. So I just threw on my Pink Floyd playlist and just hit random and just was listening to that while I was clearing this out. And I've almost used up all of my Diamond Unbreaking 3 pickaxe. So, but when I get this cleared off to the top here, I'm gonna go above this and use the ceiling as a floor and cut out another 7. Can I reach you? Aha. Another 7 layers. And that would make it up to 15, because we've got 7 here, then the floor, then 7 more. and I have a little bit up top already cut out, and so this will be 20 high. I'm gonna get back to work on this. I'm gonna probably have to mine again. Believe it or not, cutting out all this, I only got 4 diamonds, and my diamond down to 2 right now. So I need one more to fix this pickaxe. I mean, I could just, maybe I'll just do that so I can continue working. I could just throw it in an anvil and throw diamonds at it, which will repair it, but it's not the most efficient way to repair them. But I have Fortune 2 on this. I don't really care for Fortune 2. I want the Fortune 3. So we might. It's not, the Great Hall is not done, but the digging part is done and some work on the other stuff. So let me go show you what I have done. Oh, there's my hoe. Like, I got lost in there. So, this is the area that I've dug out. It is a little bit bigger than I had originally wanted. When I started the episode and I said I was going to dig out a hall, I was thinking it was going to be around that, maybe this far. And I'm thinking, well, this would be a good place to do what I was doing on the Minecraft Uncut series, which is make these towers. And this is my smaller tower base, because the big tower base that I had for the initial Minecraft Uncut would actually be in the way of this. So I had to really condense it to make the small tower base. But I'm going to keep the base. I'm not sure if I'm going to keep the diorite here. I might just make it out of stone, because most of this wall is going to be stone and not diorite. But I've also started trying to place the floors down. I have to move my villagers up to the top or wherever I'm going to place them. So I've dug this out, and I'm working on some designs. And this is going to be called the Great Mining Hall, I guess. Ceiling's going to be, all these holes are going to be gone, and it's going to look nice. I don't think I'm going to have to add some lighting. Initially, I was going to have it bright down here. Then I'm like, well, if I half slab the floor, I don't even have to add lights. I mean, I have lights here just because things can spawn on this, and I don't want creepers blowing stuff up. But with the half slabs, I don't know if I want the darkness. So I think I'm going to add in these sections here where the corners, I might dig down two, put a bucket of lava down there, cover it up with glass, and just have a little dip here. I don't know, with light coming out of there. I don't know really what else to do. So please, if you have an idea of how I can light this floor up, let me know. I was thinking of putting some lava pots up in the top too, so the ceiling shines a little bit better. But those are like finishing touches, so I'm not really too worried about it. But I just wanted to show you the progress of cutting this out. And I've also worked a little bit on a doorway that I'm thinking of using. Like this would be a mining shaft, and it'd be the exact same thing on the other side. And I think pretty much this is going to be it. I'm not 100% sure if I like the lava in the middle. I don't know. It's a little too square for me. There's something missing in this, but this is pretty close to it. So let me know if you have any ideas on that. And over here, I'm going to have a storage area and probably a mining area over there. I don't know. And this is on a slime chunk. So how many? I got 14 arrows. I need some serious mob farms. So there's a couple of slime chunks here, and the ceiling is at level 31. So I could put 2 levels of slime farm on the ceiling, and I may have a thing where it does that and drops, kills the slimes and drops the balls down here somewhere, and somehow maybe escort them to a chest in there, because it doesn't take long to get a double chest of slime balls when you have a slime farm. So that is gonna be what's happening in the future. And I gotta, find a place to store all this. These are all filled with crap. So I'm going to build the storage room down here, obviously, because I'm going to be moving a lot of blocks even when this is done. So the tunnels are going to be on that end and that end over there. While... Oh, a little too high. While the storage room's going to be over here and possibly the other room over there. I don't know what the other room would be. I'm thinking, obviously, enchanting table room. Maybe a brewing room. Maybe a combination of the two over here. And then to hide this a little bit better. Kind of wish I brought this down a couple of notches. I could bring it down a couple of notches and have the exit over here. But I think I'm just going to make a pillar thing like this. A base around this. Maybe the full size one. 1, 2, 3, 4. The full size one would actually go all the way out here. That's a little too big. But somehow I'll make this look good. I'll replace a couple of the stone blocks and replace them with diorite just to even everything out. But I'm going to work on this a little bit more and I'll come back and in the video show you what I've got. I'm not going to wait. Oops. I was just about to say, I'm not going to waste my arrow on a bat, and I didn't switch my thing. Now I want to kill you because I wasted an arrow on you, but I don't have enough arrows yet. Guess I got to definitely make some mob grinders and stuff. So I'm hoping you like the way this looks, and I will be right back with some more. The top of the pillars will have a thing that blends it into the wall also, and there'll be a stripe going across there, and then a stripe going there, and a stripe. You'll see when it's done. But to give you an idea, when I was working on the Minecraft Uncut, and I was gonna make a huge room, this room right here is about 1/8 of what my plan was for that series. So initially, when I do end up working, streaming the other series, part of the thing I'll be streaming is working on a room that's 8 times the size of this one. And it has the pillars going to the top with the huge bottoms. I don't remember how tall that was supposed to be, but it's comparable to the height here. But it didn't have this in the middle. This kind of really breaks up the room. I wish I hadn't made that now. I didn't have plans to make such a big room like this, though. But I'll be back and I'll show you what I've done. I'm not going to finish it in this episode, but I'll show you a little more progress. And I got a Valibus. I got to go. I have finished all the walls. The walls are how I want them. Eventually, maybe someday, like over here, I've decided I'm going to put in some storage. I might put in a picture of a diamond pickaxe or sword, the pixel art on the walls eventually at some day and put pixel art on the walls. But right now, before I have multiple blocks, colored blocks, I'm just going to leave these walls blank. But understand that in the future, these walls are going to have some pixel art and some stuff to cut them up a little bit. But basically, this video has been running a little long, so I'm going to go with a quick thing. I put in the pillars. I had to, or the base for the pillars. I got rid of my portal, and over here I got rid of some of my enchantment area, so I need to make an enchantment room, and I think I'm gonna do something on these edges to put everything in it, because there's gonna be nothing on the floor in this room except for this, which I may put down to ground level here. I may just move all this down one level or two levels. I think that's what I'm going to do. So, I have to go because this video is almost 30 minutes long and we're not going to have a 30 minute video. No, we're not. No. No 30 minute video here. So I'm going to go and you're just going to have to wait for my next video. Okay? I promise it will be good, and I promise it will probably be the last one that's down here. Then we can go see the sun again, because I'm feeling like Gollum. Yeah, no, we don't like feeling like Gollum. So goodbye. This is Keith from KMA's Korner. Have a good night.